So, have any of you ever reloaded ShotShell before?
I'll take that as a no.
That's perfect, because today I'm here to basically tell you and show you just the different steps of how to reload a shotgun shell. From step one, this, to step two, for load one, with a few different materials. For those of you who do not know, this is a ShotShell loader. Different stuff on it, like I got my powder, which would be shot, stuff like that. Shot shell, for those of you who do not know, is basically what you put into your shotgun. It's loaded with many different types of projectiles that will fire off at certain animals, clay pigeons, just stuff like that. Pretty simple, but it can come in many different shot sizes, gauges, stuff like that. The smaller number that you get on the shot or the gauge, normally it's the bigger the round or the projectiles that fire out. So to begin with, here is a comparison between some of the different gauges. I will be loading 12 gauges today, which is right here, the clear one. There's many different types of them. There's bigger ones, which come really big. One of the bigger ones was the 2-gauge, which was invented a while back. It was very huge. Two guys had to hold it. It's really not used today because it would blow your arm off almost. Another different comparison would be the barrel size, which fits the bullet. When my dad was a kid, shot shell loading used to be a lot more common because whenever you went to go and shoot your shot shells, you wouldn't want to go and buy brand new ones because it was kind of expensive. But today, very few people do it, considering that, well, very few people have interest in doing it, actually. And it kind of gets expensive nowadays. As I looked around the room, very few of you knew how to shot shell reload or ever do it in your life. But that's why I'm here today, is basically to show you from step one to the final step, finishing it. I've reloaded since I was about 4 or 5 years old. Different types of shells, like rifle shells, 223 shells, just stuff like that. But I just recently have started shotgun shells, which are a tinge of it simpler, considering you have your shot shell loader, which you don't measure everything out perfectly. Ever since I reloaded or set up our shot shell reloader about 2 or 3 weeks ago, we have reloaded about 500 rounds to it. But before I need to do, I'm going to show you how to resize using this, reprime, fill with shot and powder, and finally crimp if you still. By the way, this is 100% safe because instead of using powder, which is highly explosive, I will be using ground up corn cobs basically. And instead of using actual primers, I'll be using dummy rounds basically. So they won't explode. To begin, you gotta resize and crimp. The reason for resizing is because when this bullet is shot off, the powder, which is explosive, like I said, is stored in this brass, the gold area basically. When it explodes by using the primer, it expands, which can barely fit back into your shotgun. So in order to fit it back inside, you need to put it in this thing. And this thing does two jobs. As you can see, this little bar here is used for also pulling out the old primer, which would look like one of these. So you push this in here. Push it down. Does them. It's resized so you can put it back into your shotgun and it can fit a little bit nicer. Basically, what is next is putting the new primer back into it, which, like I said, I'm going to be using dummy rounds, so it will explode on me, I hope. But put it there. Set this here. And now it has primer inside of it. Whereas before, it would have just a hollow hole. The reason for repriming is pretty simple. basically, if you don't have a new primer in it, the powder will ignite, and when you go to fire the shot, nothing will ever happen. So it's a worth the spend round. A primer basically is a tiny single-use device. When you hit on one side, basically it emits flames into the actual shotgun shell, igniting the powder, which will explode, causing all the projectiles to fly out. The next part you got to do is insert the powder, the wad, and the shot. So I take that same round, and I stuff it here. This is filled with my powder, or my ground corn cob. This is shot, and my wad is right here. This bar right here, when you push it over, it fills up with the other side. Like I said, I'm going to be using corn cob, so right now it's filled with corn cob inside there. When I push it over though, slip this down, it fills up. So as you can see inside of there, if you're close enough, is some ground corn cob. That would be my powder. But the next thing you gotta do, you don't start off by just putting in the shot, or as most people would think. You have to divide it out or else it would explode inside of your actual shotgun when you go to shoot it. So insert this wad, which divides it up. It divides the two out. Gets inserted right up here. Top the shotgun. Shell. Insert into the wad. Now it has a primer inside, so you can insert your shot. What shot is basically is it's little round lead balls. They can come in steel, lead, stuff like that. The smaller the number, normally the bigger the shot. One of the bigger ones is slug, as you know. A couple others are buckshot, stuff like that. But I will be using number 5 shot, which is actually pretty small. See, stuff in. Push it back over. And as you can see, it's full of shot. So basically, when you go to fire it out, it has shot. But the final step is basically you have to make sure the ingredients that you have put inside of here don't fall out. How you do that is you crimp it. Crimping is where you take these sides like this, which normally you would see on a shotgun shell, are folded inwards. You take those and you fold them in on a new shell. But first, I have created a special kind of technique. Cut these little circles out of a random piece of paper. It doesn't really matter. It doesn't affect the projectile speed or whatever. You stuff that inside of it, helps so the shot doesn't fall out and land all over your floor or whatever. You stuff it in this starter crimp. In the starter crimp, push it down, and it starts off the crimp, as you can see. It folds. Put it in the finalizing crimp, and you push it down. Now, as you can see, it's fully folded. So you can try to tip it out all you want. Nothing's going to ever come out of this until you fire it. The different types of shot, like I already said, come in many different styles. I was using 5 shot, which is this one right up here. It's very, very small. They come in a lot bigger sizes. Basically, I have shown you how to do all the different steps of reloading from start to finish, starting with the resizing to fit it back in. The repriming, the filling with shot and powder in the wand, and the crimping. Basically, those of you who don't know how to reload, I'll show you something, maybe you have a slight interest in it. Maybe you could start sometime. One tip of advice I would like to give is it starts off a little bit tricky because you have to measure all the shot out, like this bar here. You have to drill it to the right size. You have to drill it all up right size and make sure basically that you get enough powder in there or enough shot. But it starts off hard and kind of tricky when you figure it all out and you have to go through some books and maybe get experience from your dad or your grandpa or whatever. But it gets really easy afterwards. Basically, as you can see, it's pretty easy from start to finish. It's just a few different steps from this thing. Total of about 5. So even someone like Alec can figure it out.
That's basically it, all there is to it. Thank you for listening to my speech.